Welcome back. When I was a kid, we never used museums as a place to go and do stuff, did you?
No, you
I just remember
walking through and seeing like old things behind glass.
Yeah, relics and archives. Uh-huh. And so today we're gonna learn all about the Heritage Museum of Orange County from the executive director, Kevin Cabrera. Thank you so much for coming in and bringing all of this incredible information. I'm so excited to learn what really goes on in a museum today. This is super cool.
We do a lot, and I totally get where you're coming from, where it's, you know, looking at things behind glass. Heritage Museum, our motto is hands-on, minds-on.
I love
where
that.
Where you're having that hands-on experience, learning, interacting with objects, interacting with the past. But then the minds-on component, where we are actually getting to critically think about these things and posing questions that make you think about why things occurred and who these people are and why they're important and things of that nature.
That's amazing. So what ages are you working with?
So our main demographic is the elementary level. Okay. We see about 18,000 students that visit the museum grounds every year.
Wow.
But we serve as young as preschoolers all the way up to seniors and elderly. Mm-hmm. But our main demographic are the students.
And do you have organized programs for all of those ages?
We do.
Oh, wow.
We do.
Okay.
Our elementary programs range from kindergarten to fifth grade. We have some developing some after-school middle school programs and some high school programming that incorporates more history and art, as you see in some of the
I was noticing some of these like super fun canvas pictures. Mm-hmm. Are these done by the students?
Yes.
Oh wow.
Yeah, that's done by a program that we've developed called the People's History of Orange County.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really having the students learn and engage about a broad variety of topics of Orange County's history. So we do bring in guest speakers. Uh-huh. We have special exhibits that we've created. We do field trips. So we actually field trip and they actually like walk historical neighborhoods
meet
people.
That's amazing.
And then we kind of culminate the program with allowing them to do some sort of art or creative piece. So these are some of the artworks, but we've had students actually create short stories, make poems, design t-shirts. So it's all about their learning experience and what they've learned, and then how they take that knowledge to create a piece they're gonna remember.
I love that. So I'm a transplant to Orange County from Utah originally.
And me from New York City.
Yes, and I've been here for 14 years now, but what is the origin of Orange County? Like I've heard a lot about San Juan Capistrano and the missions there, but how did Orange County actually get started?
So that's a very unique story because Orange County was actually part of Los Angeles County up until 1889.
Oh.
And you had a group of people that came together that actually wanted to secede from Los Angeles County. And eventually it worked. They had failed two times prior.
Okay.
And on the third time they finally seceded and started their own county. So you had to think about it. In the 1880s, Orange County was very diverse, very open.
Mm.
And so main government was up in Los Angeles.
Mm.
So origins dates back to the late 1800s, but then you also have Spanish history, Mexican history, and then we also have our Native American history as well.
Sure.
Yeah, that's amazing. I love everything about Orange County. I love living here, and I love that there is a lot of diversity. I live down closer to the military base, and then there's Newport, which has its own flavor, and San Juan that has its own flavor, and it's just it's a beautiful county.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And let's talk about the oranges, because you guys do not only the student programs, but you've got partnerships and product. And
exactly.
You've really gone in every direction possible.
So we actually grow oranges. We grow citrus.
Wow.
So here's some of our Valencia oranges, which is our summer fruit, but we grow tangerines as well, grapefruit, lemons, limes. So it's You know, everyone associates Orange County with orange trees, and right. there's no orange trees around anymore.
I've never seen one.
So we actually grow them, and our students get to taste them. We sell, we have a little farm stand where we sell. We have a 2-acre produce farm, so
wow.
Orange County agriculture is grown there. And then in regards to partnerships, yeah, we have the Blinking Owl, which is a partner of ours. It's actually the first distillery in Orange County since Prohibition.
Wow.
And they utilize our oranges to make their orange flavored vodka.
Oh, I love
that. And I'm not a vodka person, but it's actually pretty tasty. It's pretty tasty. So yeah, that's you know, some of the unique things that we've added, thinking outside the box. And I know we have a couple breweries who are interested in our grapefruits and wanting to do some grapefruit flavored beer.
That's so cool.
So we'll see how that
goes.
That's great.
Yeah. That's
I
cool.
see you've got a, yeah, something that looks a little dangerous
this
sitting
is,
right there.
This is a meat turner. So you like to barbecue?
I do.
Turn your meat. So this is a meat turner.
Mine doesn't look like that.
This it looks like this because it's handmade.
That's beautiful.
We have a fully functioning coal blacksmith shop at the museum grounds.
Uh-huh. Wow.
And so we do blacksmith demonstration for our students. We teach classes. And so you make things. So it's like
cool.
you're really doing, so like actually my ring.
Oh my gosh.
This, I made this.
Oh, that's beautiful. Was that a train nail?
Yes. Or? Yeah, so it's an old nail. I kind of, let's see if I can pull it out. I nippled it all around and then just curled it through.
Look wow. at that. That's beautiful.
So yeah, blacksmithing is an art
camera.
In itself. And
that's very cool.
And it's fun. So
and thank you.
We have
I'm picturing kindergartners taking the anvil and a hammer on it and going, do they do that or what do they do?
The students don't get to get into the anvil because, you know, obviously coal forges, it's hot, it's an open flame.
Sure.
But we have puzzles that they get to play mm-hmm. with. They get to we'll make them a nail. The students will get a mail made for them.
Oh,
and then we
cool.
also have our Heritage Museum brand.
Oh.
So we actually brand
oh.
this.
That's neat.
And the students get to take it back to their classroom.
Very wow. So you have an adult working the hot stuff.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
Yeah. The kids are not branding each other.
Yeah, I wasn't worried about that, but clearly you were. But the thing that I do worry about, it looks like a jewelry bag there. What would be hiding in a little velvet bag?
So one of my favorite programs that we offer at the museum is our fourth grade gold rush unit. And we utilize our nature preserve, and the students, you know, act like they're actually walking the westward journey to California during the gold rush. And so in here we have our little we have our gold, because at the end of their journey, when they make it to California, they actually get to do some little panning for gold.
Oh my goodness.
So,
oh my amazingness. Is this actually gold?
That is actual
gold. It's actual gold.
Yeah, and we have some silver here.
Oh,
so
my
a little bit of
goodness.
A tidbit of Orange County history, gold. Silverado Canyon.
I need
Canyon.
To bring my kids over. Okay, so
totally.
how do we get over there?
It's actually just right up to 405. So come up right up to 405. Exit Fairview, and we're about 2 miles north. So
oh
we're on the board
gosh.
On the border of Santa Ana and Costa Mesa. So you have that silver in your hand.
Wonderful.
So Orange County history, Silverado Canyon used to be a silver mine.
Uh-huh.
And then we also have a little bit of copper here as well.
Wow.
Yeah.
Excellent. Let's give it a
sure.
Back. Kevin, thank you so much for bringing all of this great information. And I know our viewers are going to be looking for you. So how can they find you?
Visit us on our website, heritagemuseumoc.org. We're also on Facebook, we're on Instagram. But yeah, we're here at 3101 West Harvard in Santa Ana, California.
Okay.
And we're open Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays to the public. Monday through Fridays, we have all the kiddos running around and enjoying the grounds and learning hands-on.
This is amazing. Thank you so much for coming to share with us. I hope you'll come back again.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. And we'll be right back.